thank you sa mga nag-greet pala birthday ko. So I turned 29. Yan, bata pa guys, no. Nasa kalendaryo pa. So meron pa akong 2 years bago tayo mawala sa kalendaryo. And thank you. Mukha lang 28, no. One year lang yung age gap natin sa actual age pati sa facial age. Ayun, anong kailangan mo, Sir Darren? Meron ka bang kailangan, sir? PM mo lang ako after ng podcast natin. Ayan, thank you guys. Thank you sa late greetings. And appreciate it so much. Iba talaga, no, pag may trading community ka. Okay, every day is really special. Not only in terms of, ano, no, in terms of learning from the community, but also just a feeling na you have someone to share your struggles as a trader. So if nakita nyo naman, diba, sa PSE channel, recently may shinare ako doon regarding my recent performance sa personal portfolio ko. So nakita nyo yung rise and fall ng equity curve natin, no, in the past months. And syempre yung struggles natin, yung mga losing streaks natin, yung misplays. Okay, that's normal in trading. And hopefully that gave you something to relate to, and maybe hope din na okay, normal lang pala yung ganun. And even if you are in that track, you're still on the right track, even na you have a system and you have a community here in TR. Sige, so for tonight guys, meron akong gustong i-discuss na lagi kong nakikita sa mga feedback. Okay? Feedback sa community natin, and not only sa community natin but even outside our trading community. This is a very common problem that is happening sa mga typical traders, and that is information overload. So bago natin i-discuss to, I'd like to give some commendation lang dito kay Ma'am Jessa. Ayan, kasi siya yung sponsor ulit ng question natin for tonight. Okay, ito yung ano niya, ito yung full question niya na nasa idea note natin. Okay, so basahin natin. Wait, yan, nawala. So, how to manage info overload? Pinost niya to last month. So, TR channels, FGDs, Ask ZFT, TR Radio. Meron pa tayong The Drive na kailangan mong i-unlock, di ba? Yung books, podcasts, audibles, review of ZFT course lesson. Sobrang daming need at gustong matutunan. Paano po i-handle ang pagiging overwhelmed with too much resources to learn from? Sometimes, no, ito yung nagiging problem pag nasa isang community ka full of like-minded people, because everyone has a lot to share, right? Hindi siya yung tulad na pag ikaw lang yung naghahanap ng sarili mong information or yung personal pursuit mo for knowledge, you can do your own filtering. So you decide na, okay, tonight, so manonood lang ako ng YouTube video ni Rainer Teo. Yan. Lagi kong naririnig yung trader na to, so I think maganda yung content niya. And then bukas, babasahin ko yung Trading in the Zone na libro ni Mark Douglas. So you can create your own schedule if you do your personal screening. But once you are in a community with like-minded people, ang daming content na magsisilabasan dyan. So parang sa community natin, dito sa Discord, no, dito sa TR, sobrang daming channels, webinars, and all of this stuff. How do you actually handle all this information? So yun yung question ni Ma'am Jessa. So, sabi niya, having this abundance is not bad. In fact, it's a good thing, di ba? Kasi, andyan na lahat eh. Ikaw na lang pipili kung ano yung babasahin mo, ano yung papanoorin mo. But, there is stress, okay? So, highlight natin. No? Nasistress siya, and na-overwhelm siya with so many good things and so many possibilities. So, when there's so much to study from, how do we get the most of them without being too overwhelmed? So, sa mga nandito ngayon, sino yung nakaka-relate kay Ma'am Jessa? Sino yung nakaka-relate? You can raise your hand or siguro you can type sa chat natin. Okay. Who here is experiencing information overload inside PR? Or maybe in trading as a whole? So, the first thing that I can say about this problem is it's a very typical problem for any type of trader. Yung iba kasi iniisip nila, you only suffer information overload if you are the type of person na gusto mong or mahilig kang mag-seek ng knowledge. Okay, like, for example, ako, when I don't know something, ang first step ko talaga is to research a lot about it. So, it's what I did with trading, it's what I did with NFTs, with Axie, and kung ano pa yung mga pinasok kong engagements. No? So, I seldom just jump into the dark. Yung parang, yung sinasabi nila, parang you just take a blind leap in the dark or a leap of faith without first exploring the risk and rewards of a certain engagement or a certain venture. So, sabi nila, yung information overload, it's something na common to those, yung ganong klaseng tao, parang ako. Pero actually, it's not. Lalo na in trading. Because in trading, the moment you engage into the markets, agad-agad, siguro it will take less than a month para ma-realize mo na hindi mo pala talaga alam kung ano yung ginagawa mo dyan. Or for some people na medyo may ego sila when it comes to their knowledge, when it comes to their understanding of themselves, na iniisip nila na magaling sila, maybe it will take them 2 to 3 months bago nila ma-realize na, ang dami ko palang hindi alam pagdating sa trading. But for the typical trader, it just takes less than a month. Or maybe less than a trade. Or less than 2 trades or 3 trades. Ma-realize mo na, bakit ako natatalo when I have this certain prediction or marunong naman ako magbasa ng charts, then why am I experiencing these losses? So, the moment you enter into that state, automatically, yung magiging parang tendency mo is to seek information. Right? And the problem now is if you go online and just search for technical analysis or trading, sobrang daming lalabas na references and you don't know kung saan dyan yung valid or saan dyan yung pwede mong maging starting point. Okay? But that's normal. And yun yung first na dapat maintindihan natin as traders or for some of you as starting traders. You cannot avoid information overload. Okay? Especially if you are part of TR. Kasi dito sa TR, we have everything, right? Regardless of the market, NFT ba yan, crypto, PSE, meron tayo dito. So, if it's normal, then shouldn't it be not a problem? Kasi kung normal siya, if it's a normal phase in your trading journey, then hindi talaga siya problem. It's more of a phase, right? And for me, that's my understanding of information overload. Lahat tayo dumaan dyan. And since it's a phase, it's a matter of not really avoiding it, but more of moving forward from it. Okay, gets nyo ba yun? So, if you are in this phase, ano yung kailangan mong gawin para maka-move forward ka? So, this might sound parang unrelated to our topic for tonight, but ito yung nakikita kong ano no, ito yung nakikita kong way to address information overload. The first thing that you have to do is to identify what kind of trader are you. Okay, so dito sa Ask ZFT, meron tayong episode wherein I discussed yung niche. So finding your profile. Ano-ano ba yung mga profile, sir? So I think most of us are familiar with it. We have swing trading, we have trend following, we have momentum trading, then we have day trading, scalping, position trading, diba? So, I hope familiar tayo of these different profiles. Now, in your first year or first 2 years of your trading, hindi mo talaga malalaman exactly kung anong klaseng profile yung meron ka as a trader. So, it will take a lot of data gathering and it will also take a lot of trial and error para malaman mo kung anong trader ka, anong klaseng trader ka. Okay? So, the first thing that you have to do in this phase, okay, in knowing who you are as a trader is yun, gathering data. And secondly, it's more of looking at your trades, yung actual trades mo. Dapat syempre, gina-journalize mo yun, no? And makita mo sa journal mo kung anong part dyan sa yung equity curve na nakikita mo na you see progress. Okay? Or nakita mong yun yung nagiging reason why at the end of the day, meron kang profits. Okay? So, once you know that part in your equity curve, you can pwede kang scale into that para makita mo kung ano yung dapat lang bigyan mo ng focus. And everything else outside of that circle, okay, na na-identify mo na doon ka magaling, kailan mo na yung i-filter out all of it and just focus on that certain strength na meron ka as a trader. Now, this is easier said than done kasi I know a lot of traders na 3 years, 4 years na sila, they still don't know exactly kung ano yung trader profile nila. But so long as hindi mo ma-identify yun, you will always be guilty of information overload. Kasi you will have that, you will have that desire to know everything. And you will have that mindset na if you don't know everything, if hindi mo makabisado yung ganitong setup, yung ganitong profile, then you won't be consistently profitable. But that is not the case in trading. Okay, it's sometimes yung sobrang dami mong alam, yun pa yung nagiging reason kung bakit hinihila yung performance mo pababa. Okay? So, I won't delve into that too much kasi meron na akong podcast for that. So, go to Hot Money sa Spotify and search for identifying your niche. So, panoorin niyo yun para mas ma-expound itong part na to sa discussion ko. Okay? So, ayan. Traders feel information overload when they don't know exactly what they need. So, how do you know exactly what you need? So, yun. First step is identifying your profile. What's the next step? Okay, the next step is recognizing that trading is not just a science. Okay? Yung typical understanding natin is trading is a technical activity. Ibig sabihin nun, you need to know a lot about technical analysis, about numbers, risk management, even math, di ba? Kasi may konting math sa trading eh. Di ba? Probabilities, that's mathematics. So you need to know all this technical stuff for you to be consistently profitable. So the moment pumasok ka sa TR, nakita mo yung mga channels na sobrang daming discussions doon from TSE to crypto. Tapos, di ba, meron pa tayong parang dedicated channel per indicator. Isipin nyo yun, like, meron tayong exclusive channel for moving averages, for RSI, wherein all the questions that are posted about those elements of the ZFT system, makikita mo doon. And then, of course, you have the drive. Diba na, iba't ibang, ano na yun, mga specialized topics na. Kumbaga, doon sa drive, explore how to do momentum trading, how to do swing trading, market recognition, diba? So, nandun lahat. Now, this gives the impression na if you're a trader, you need to be very scientific. And alam naman natin, di ba, na sa science, mas marami kang alam, mas maganda. Kasi, kumbaga, you're not ignorant of the other concepts. But we forget na trading is also an art. And when we say trading is an art, it means that there is a certain uniqueness about it that is personal to you. Yung way mo of trading, okay, as a market participant, as a unique market participant, is entirely different from how I trade or how Boss Z trades, even if pareho tayo ng mga profiles. So, I think isa yan sa naging problem ko din before kasi akala ko, ang kailangan ko is meron akong certain role model na dapat ma-emulate ko, na exactly kung ano yung ginagawa niya, dapat ginagawa ko rin. So, in the past, I have Boss Z and yung mga dating ZFT mentors. I look up to them so much na I wanted to study everything na ginagawa nila. And hopefully, ma-integrate yon sa sarili kong process. But what I found out along the years is, yes, nakatulong siya. Pero I lost my identity as a market participant, as a trader. And yung identity mo na yon is very important. Okay. Sa TIP, ito usual discussion ko when I talk about the different processes that I have, from screening my stocks to yung personal trading routine ko before I trade the markets, even yung mga mindsetting na ginagawa ko, yung meron akong mga nire-recite sa sarili ko before I trade. So all of those stuff dinidiscuss ko yun, but after the discussion I always tell my students na, okay, this is my process. what's yours? Okay? Ano yung unique naman sa process mo? Kasi if you don't have that unique element in your process, then it would be very difficult for you to follow that or to integrate that into your trading process. Kasi hindi siya match sa personality mo eh. Okay? So, that's the second thing that I think is very important to handle this problem. You need to consider or you need to acknowledge that trading is also an art. It's a unique activity and it can be personalized. Hindi mo kailangan malaman lahat ng ginagawa ng ibang traders para lang maging effective trader ka. And most of the time, if you interview yung mga consistently profitable traders, they will tell you na yung naging eureka moment nila or yung naging turning point nila sa trading nila is when they started to look inward instead of looking outward or searching for more information. Okay? So that's number two. Okay. Number three, when you experience information overload, always remember na with information that you have, you can always screen through the information. You can always filter through the information. Now, yung filtering process mo dyan won't happen overnight. Okay? In fact, yung typical roadmap ng isang trader is ganito, di ba? Ito, diniscuss ko din to sa dating mga podcast natin. So, you start with knowing, you think you know everything, di ba? So, yun yung tinatawag nating ano ba yun? Nakalimutan ko yung term. Something to do with competence, no? So, unconscious incompetence. Okay? Do you remember that discussion sa mga dating naka-attend ng podcast ko on that? Yung roadmap to trading success? So, you always start with what we call unconscious incompetence. Ibig sabihin, akala mo magaling ka, but hindi ka talaga magaling. So, we always start with that level and then you begin to realize na, uy, wait lang, hindi pala ako competent. So, you become consciously incompetent. And then from there, okay, since unconscious incompetence is that phase na lahat gusto mong malaman, doon mo lang ma-realize when you become conscious of your incompetence, doon mo ma-realize na I need to filter through the information that I have. So, I guess what I'm trying to say here is, it's okay na you have that desire to know everything and you have that tendency to be overloaded with information because of that desire. And you can actually turn that into a good thing. Okay? Ang kailangan lang is meron kang filtering process or filtering mechanism. So, if you ask yourself now, with all that I know about the ZFT system, with all that I know about trading, what's my personal process para malaman ko kung ano lang yung kailangan ko dito? Okay? So, malalaman mo yan, no, na you are reaching a level of maturity when it comes to your trading knowledge, when instead of wanting to learn more, ang ginagawa mo na is you're now trimming. Okay? Nagtitrim ka na kung ano yung hindi mo kailangan and you are improving or enhancing kung ano yung kailangan mo. So, take for instance, si Ken, di ba? Meron siyang mga elements in the ZFT system na hindi na niya masyado ginagamit. Is that wrong? Okay? Siyempre, ZFT system yan. So, dapat lahat yan ginagamit mo, di ba? Yung MAs, yung RSI, and all of those elements. But, eventually, it will come to a point na may mga parts dyan na hindi mo na gagamitin. Si Boss Z, dumaan din sa ganong phase, no? If you try to read his blog, makikita niya doon yung mga earliest posts niya back in 2015-2016. Sobrang gulo pa ng system niya. I mean, when I say magulo, it doesn't mean na pangit. Ha? It just means na ang dami pang mga redundant elements na nag-o-overlap. Okay? Gumagamit siya ng MACD, gumagamit siya ng FastK. Di ba? May mga indicators doon na even today, hindi na siya ganun ka-common. Okay, nandoon sa system niya. But as you read further sa blog, makita nyo na nag-trim down siya until he arrived with the ZFT system. Okay? So, that's one of the things that you have to integrate in your process, yung filtering mechanism mo. So again, this is subjective. Okay, hindi pwede na, kunwari ako, sasabihin ko na ako, hindi ako masyado gumagamit ng Fibonacci kasi I'm just using Darvas and basic supports and resistances and moving averages as my basis for my trading. Okay? And sasabihin ko sa inyo na, okay, dapat ganun din kayo ha, dapat ganun din yung ginagawa nyo. Huwag nyo nang tingnan yung Fibonacci, ma-information overload lang kayo. So, hindi pwedeng ganun. Kasi again, this is personal. Okay? So, yun. Having that filtering mechanism. So, once you have, or once you do those three things, okay, yung number one is being able to acknowledge that information overload is normal, and then identifying your niche, which is entirely a distinct process din. And number three, having that filtering mechanism when it comes to information, it would be easy for you to handle information overload. Okay? The moment titingin ka sa Discord channel natin, di ba? Sobrang daming, ayan o. Ewan ko kung naka-unlock sa inyo lahat ng channels natin, but the moment you look at all these channels, may mga specific channels na lang dyan na alam mo na doon ka tatambay or doon ka magbababad. So for example, if you know for yourself at this point na it's not good or it's not conducive for you to learn crypto kasi you're still starting and you know, you acknowledge the fact that crypto is a hard market, then obviously, hindi ka na dapat muna bibigay ng too much time or too much focus sa crypto channel natin. Yes, you can siguro backread and try to get an idea of what the crypto market is through the engagement in the channel, but less of that na and just focus on the PSA discussions. Okay? So diba, napaka-basic lang, but it's something na a lot of us find hard to do kasi siguro yung mindset natin is pag nasa TR ka and this is a paid community, dapat na ma-maximize mo yung investment mo dito. So nagbayad ka sa TI, you paid for TR. So dapat lahat makuha mo in one go. But what you don't realize is if ganun yung magiging mindset mo or you magpapadala ka sa ganung klaseng tendency mo, you're getting less value from your investment in knowledge. Kasi nagkaka overlap na lahat. Hindi na nahahandle ng mind mo yung pumapasok. So why not have this filtering first before you get knowledge? Okay, dapat meron kang listahan or meron kang parang personal outline sa kung ano yung gusto mong ma-master or ano yung gusto mong malaman for this year or for this month or for this week. Or you can go daily, di ba? For today, dapat ang focus ko lang is this specific topic. Any topic outside of this topic, hindi ko siya dapat bigyan masyado ng pansin. Okay? So yun, taking bite-sized pieces as you search or as you gather knowledge for your personal trading process. So I think that's my way of handling information overload. That is what worked for me. I'm not sure if it's the same effect sa inyo, if ganun yung ginawa nyo. Pero I believe na that's a good framework to follow. Okay? So, now that I have discussed yung personal viewpoints ko on this problem or in this concept, I'd like to get some feedback from you guys. Okay, sa mga nandito ngayon. Okay, so, ayan. So, merong sinabi si Maki dito sa kanyang, dito sa chat natin. No? So, yung tendency daw to feel FOMO sa other channels. Ayan. Nandito ba si Sir Maki? Are you here, sir? Ako nandito siya. Ayan. So, maka-ano ka ba? Wait, kabit lang ako naman. Sige. Para may konteng discussion tayo about information overload. Ito kasi guys, no, it's a very common problem. Kaya minsan parang ini-ignore lang natin siya. Ah, information overload. That's normal naman. Pero you don't know how it affects your trading journey until ma-realize mo na lang na parang, wait lang, sobrang delayed na ako sa progress ko. Ah. And then you identified yung problem pala is kasi sobrang dami mong gustong pagsabay-sabay, pagsabay-sabayin. And yun yung gusto natin i-address for this podcast. Okay, so okay lang, Sir Maki. I appreciate if maka open mic ka. May question lang ako dito sana sa ano, sa sinabi mo na FOMO. Okay? Ah, okay, sige. Okay lang. So anyway, yung sinasabi kasi ni Sir Maki na FOMO, ito yung, I think ito yung parang nafe-feel ng mga nasa TR na pag may ganap sa isang channel, like kunwari, Bitcoin just broke out. Yan. Actually, nag-break out yung Bitcoin recently, di ba? Parang nag-60K na siya. So, Bitcoin just broke out. Sobrang ingay doon sa crypto channel. And ikaw na you're still in that phase na nasa PSE ka pa. So, you're studying this very basic long market only. Nakita mo, wow, grabe. Ganito pala sa crypto. Sobrang daming ganap. Gabi-gabi, araw-araw, may nangyayaring play. And then doon na, papasok yung FOMO. Tapos you will feel na, siguro dapat mag-crypto na din ako. Pagsabayin ko na lang sa PSE. Okay? But your mind is not ready for that kind of influx of concepts. Kasi syempre, alam natin, may mga concepts sa crypto na wala sa PSE. Diba? So, yung ganong mindset, that can be very dangerous. Siguro, no, ang masasabi ko sa mga nakaka-feel ng FOMO, which caused them to feel information overload, is yung root problem dyan is really your desire to find shortcuts to consistency. And ako, personally, I'm guilty of that as well. Even now. Diba? Siyempre, nung pumutok yung crypto market, ako na wala akong ganung ka-experience in trading, at parang inisip, okay, kaya ko lang tong ano, pag-aralan over a month, tapos magiging as consistent ako dito tulad ng performance ko sa PSE. But then I realized na it's not the case. So nagsunog din ako ng pera sa crypto, and kumbaga parang yung journey ko sa PSE when I started, it simply replicated doon sa crypto. Because I thought na I can shortcut the process. So I think yun yung talagang always na root problem sa FOMO. Not only FOMO in trading, but FOMO in knowledge as well. Yung idea na, dito ako kikita agad. Dito ako magkakapera agad. Diba? So you don't want that. Siguro pwede pag you can be really honest with yourself na kaya mo siyang pagsabayin. Pero if normally kasi hindi. Ayan.
Hello?
Ayan, sige. Ayan, si Sir Maki. So, na-mention mo, sir, yung FOMO sa other channels. Ano ba yung minimin mo exactly about this?
Yeah, one thing is yung crypto channels natin. Pero more in particular, lately, yung NFTs. So, I think more than the blockchain channel, ang mas bumulusok talaga na number of channels sa TR is yung NFT games. Tapos, you can see that, kunwari, sina Z and other members of the TR, they make money almost parang passively, di ba? Mm. Parang you don't really have to monitor it on a daily basis. Parang you can read comments like, this investment earns me like, what, 100K a day, di ba? Mm. So, parang sa una, it looks as if, yan yung pinapangarap ko eh. Yung magtatanim lang ako ng pera, tas lalago na. Ganun lang, di ba? Pero, once you realize na yung amount of research na sabi mo nga, yung amount of time that you need to dedicate for you to learn the ins and outs of that particular investment, mas uubos pala siya actually ng oras mo.
Yes.
Kesa sa, ano, di ba? Kesa sa kahit trading man yan. Kasi, na sobrang daming potentially na rug pull na games, I think mas extensive pa dapat yung ginagawa mong pag-aaral sa mga ganyan kesa sa yung trading. Kasi yung trading, ang dami ng readily information na meron sa TR, ang dami ng mentors, and NFT, ilan-ilan lang din yan. Although meron tayo ZFT Bankers, meron tayo NFT Mavericks, pero it's a relatively new environment. And as ako, ako personally, weakness ko yung nakakakita ako ng unread channels doon sa Discord ko.
Sa Discord, parang nakaka-OC siya.
Oo, so parang, at saka one thing na nakaka-OC, another thing na alam mo, paano pag itong unread na comment na to, ito yung magbibigay sa akin ng limpak-limpak na salapi, di ba? So, dahil may realization niya ako na it may look as if na madali lang yun, passive income siya, pero since I know na mas maubos pa yung oras ko kung inaral ko siya, wala, minute ko na lang yung channel, tapos hinide ko na lang sila. Kasi hindi ko talaga, kumbaga kapag ka-araw-araw ko siyang babasahin isa-isa, tapos hindi ko naman siya nagigets, wala talagang ma-info overload. Yun na yung personal take.
Yan, narinig yung sabi ni Sir Makino. So, parang if you can't handle it, just mute it. Parang ganun yung approach niya. But yun, for me kasi, no, sa age natin ngayon, there are a lot of ways to earn your first million, di ba? Sabi nila, parang iba na yung mundo ngayon. Like, you can just sit at your desk and earn lots of cash if you have the right skills and you have the right mindset. So, I think that's a very, I mean, di ba, what a time to be alive. Yan yung lagi nating sinasabi na, what a time to be alive. Sobrang daming opportunities. But sometimes, sa sobrang daming opportunities, you don't know which one to pursue or which one to give your focus. Kaya, ayan. Wait, eto pala, gusto ko din i-share, no? So, if you feel na parang na-oosi kayo dyan sa yung sobrang daming notifications, ayan, so, kunwari, ayan, no? Meron kasi sa Discord, just click Shift-Escape. Oh, ayan. Shift-Escape. Mawawala lahat ng yung parang nakalagay na tuldok na unread. Ayan. Para magbukang fresh slate siya ulit. So, may hindi nakakaalam yan. Ayan, sinabi din Sir Ish. No? Yung cut plan ko naka-flash dito sa PSC discussions. And anyway, so that's the thing with FOMO, no, in terms of knowledge. Dapat talaga you have a way to deal with that. Okay. So meron pa ditong other questions or added inputs sa chat natin. Ayan, sabi ni Doc Darren, eto ha, doctor na yung nagsasalita. So, na-realize niya daw sa ilang buwan ko sa TR na ang trading parang pagdo-doctor din yan. Correct. Diba, how many years does it take for you to master a profession? Like, for example, medicine. So, 4 years undergrad, tapos another 4 years, diba, to study yung, ano talaga, doctor degree. And then, review, tapos may residency pa, diba? So, it takes a lot of time. So, imagine mo na lang yung trading as one of the most difficult ventures and skills to have in the whole world. And you expect yourself na kaya mo yung ipagsabay-sabay lahat sa isip mo in one go. Diba? Yung ganong klaseng expectation sa sarili mo na, hindi, kaya ko to, kaya kong pagsabayin to lahat. When in fact, it's not the case. Diba? So yan, you really can't know everything. Kaya may mga specialist talaga, sabi ni Doc Darren. Acceptance na rin na di mo malalaman lahat and di mo yun mariretain. I remember also yung personal journey ko sa pagiging CPA. Kasi, ayan, sa mga hindi familiar sa CPA exam, may 7 subjects kasi yun eh. Yung time namin na, ewan ko kung ilan na, I think 5 na lang ngayon or 4. So, sa 7 subjects na yun, one of the subjects there is law. And sa law pa lang, if I try to recall lahat ng concepts na tinuro sa amin sa college, sa law, siguro sa, kunwari, 100%, mga 10% lang yung kaya talagang i-retain ng isip mo. All the rest, makakalimutan mo na yung mga provisions, articles, yung mga, ano ito, mga, meron pa yung mga mnemonics dati na kailangan na memorize namin pag-exam. So parang inisip ko, paano ko maipapasa yung subject na to when I can't even remember half of all the provisions or half of all the articles. Tapos in one review session, ito, hindi ko ito makakalimutan. Sabi nung review teacher namin, sabi niya, sa law daw, it's not about knowing all the provisions. Okay? It's about knowing the heart of the provisions or the heart of the law. Ang gusto niya sabihin doon is, lahat ng provisions na yan, lahat ng articles na yan, meron silang parang single unifying logic that holds all of them together. So it's the same thing with trading. Sometimes what we do is, parang we try to memorize or parang yung gusto mong alam mo lahat ng indicators, for example. Pero hindi mo na intindihan na lahat ng indicators and they have one single logic or isa lang yung parang basis nila, and that is price action. Diba? So, why not, instead of trying to know all the indicators at once, why not focus on price action muna? Price action is candlesticks, okay? Candlestick analysis, structures, yan. Supports and resistances, that's under yan sa price action category. Kasi once you understand price action, yung the moment you shift or the moment you try to explore indicators in depth, mas ma-appreciate mo siya or mas magiging madali siya para sa'yo. Diba? So, sometimes we try to focus talaga sa mga advanced agad. Kaya na info overload ka kasi gusto mo advanced topics agad. Pero yung basics na papabayaan mo na. Kaya nagiging mahirap siya para sa'yo. Okay? So, ayan. Ito, sabi ni Ma'am Hana, be a filter, not a sponge. Retain what's important to get you where you want to be. Okay. Maganda yung sinabi niya, pero ang struggle din dyan, okay, sa sinabi ni Ma'am Hana is, how do you know where you want to be? Okay. Ano ba yung end goal mo? Ano ba yung end point mo? Kumbaga, is it to become an effective, let's say, ang end goal mo is to become an effective, consistently profitable momentum trader. And very specific dapat yan. So if that's your end goal, anything outside of momentum trading, hindi mo masyado bibigyan ng importance. And just focus on the concepts, the discussions that are related to momentum trading. Okay, so don't forget na, yes, you have to retain what's important to you, but you need to know what your end goal is. Okay? Sige, so, any questions or siguro added inputs on this topic that you would like to share, guys? It's, again, it's a very common problem. So, I hope may mga napulot kayo sa discussion natin. Okay. Meron bang mga questions dito kanina? Wait, let me scan through it. And right, you know, wrong context, still confusion. Okay. Taking everything one day at a time. Okay, ito. Like what Boss Ken always told, wag muna sa advanced focus. Focus muna sa basics. Yes. Okay. That's another effective way of handling information overload. Okay, so any questions, guys, on this topic? Any additional inputs?
Ako, Cosmos, may dagdag ulit ako.
Yeah, sure.
Information overload. Nung relatively bago ako sa TR earlier this year, I also feel yung sentiments nung nagbigay ng question nito na sobrang damage. Actually, before lesser channels, much lesser channels.
Yes. Wala pang NFT that time eh, di ba?
Wala pang NFT that time. Pero kahit before na, yung amount of comments that you can read from various channels like yung TR sessions, kahit sa consultation FAQs, you're gonna read a lot of comments na you'd feel really important to you at that time na bago ka. Kasi lahat sila fresh eh. So, at the early stage talaga, magiging sponge ka talaga kasi you don't really know how to filter eh. Yes, you can be a filter, pero if you're not in the position to know what would be useful to you or not, then talagang salo ka na lahat ng information. Tapos parang, as the months went by, parang hindi pa rin ako nakaka-create ng sarili kong system or trajectory sa kung anong gusto kong maging 6 months from now at that time. So parang, may feel ko ngayon na alam, parang mahuhuli na ata ako kasi wala akong progress eh. That time, may acceptance na ako na I won't use my equity curve as my main metric for success or improvement. Rather, yung focus ko that time is kailangan pagkaroon ako ng playbook, yun yung pinaka ano ko that time, goal that time eh. Tapos lahat ng video sa Drive pinapanood ko. As talagang hindi siya nagme-make sense. Tapos the moment na nag-decide ako na itong particular way of trading lang yung susundan ko, lahat ng type of learning na gagawin ko moving forward, like TR Labs, like sa TIP, like sa AMI Broker, even choosing sinong mentor yung kakausapin ko, lahat yun naka-focus lang dun sa specific niche na gusto kong maging. At ang nakakagulat nun, nung ginawa ko yun, na-realize ko na dun pala sa iisang topic na yun, sobrang sasabog pa pala ng information kasi ang dami pang sub-information. Parang, nung parang ito, ito, simple example. Kunwari, Slingshot. Kunwari, Slingshot. Nababasa lahat ng TR yan. Slingshot, CTP, lahat nababasa. And, alam mo yun, ang pinaka-basic lang naman nun is RSI 70 touch and higher low. Tapos nung inaral ko na siya with my AG mates at TR Labs, tapos nung kinode ko na siya, yung filters ko sa buy pa lang, yung parameters ko sa buy pa lang, 10 na. Ibig sabihin, inaral ko yung 10 items na yun for the buy. Tapos yung selling ko, parang ngayon, yung setup ko for selling nasa 8 eh. 8 scenarios. So, mas maganda pa pala na nag-focus ako dun kasi lahat ng other information na hindi ko matagpi-tagpi before, dun na nag-make sense nung pinut into context ko siya sa isang particular subject na gusto ko mag-focus on. So, yun yung personal experience ko in handling information overload. The moment that I decided to just focus on one particular topic is the time that the other so-called overloaded information actually made sense.
Yun, ganda nun ah. Parang I think na sagot mo na din yung question ni Sir John. Sabi niya kasi dito, when you're starting daw, paano ba na-handle yung information overload? So I think, yun yung sagot ni Sir Mackie. No? More on really knowing ano yung gusto mong bigyan ng focus. And ang nakakatawa doon, sabi niya, nung nagbigay siya ng focus, hindi pa rin nawala yung information overload. Di ba? Nandun pa rin siya kasi
tama.
You have to explore pa rin eh, yung specific topic na yun. Pero ang maganda kasi doon, even if may information overload pa rin, yung information na pumapasok sa iyo hindi siya random, hindi siya yung haphazard na parang may crypto, ito may PSC, ito may RSI, ganito ganyan. So it's ano siya, parang naka-tunnel vision ka.
Kung ano
yung naka-streamline siya, kumbaga parang may ano ka na, may filter ka lang na sa outline mo na to, kahit medyo marami pa rin, alam mo na yan lang yung dapat bigyan mo ng pansin.
Yep. Ayan. Tapos, naalala ko rin si Boss Ish. Parang kung makikita natin si Boss Ish, yung sa mga comment ni Boss Ish, parang, I only trade all-time highs, tapos I buy on the breakout, tapos may particular sell signal siya. It may look as if it's very simple, pero Boss Ish is here right now. And, you know, for sure, hindi yun ganun kasi. No?
Sabi nga ni Ish dito, so for yung ano niya daw sa information overload is, and ito, maganda yung sabi niya, basically, bad news, you cannot have it all. Ayan. So, hindi pwede sa trading na parang you're an expert of all types of trading. But the good news is, you don't need it at all din. I mean, hindi mo kailangan lahat. You just need that one specific na profile or minsan nga isang setup lang eh. That will give you that certain level of focus para ma-achieve mo yung consistency. So it varies no, from trader to trader. Depende yan. It's really a matter of knowing what works for you.
Sir, just add ko na lang.
Yeah, sure.
Okay lang. Kasi siguro para dun sa mga talagang naliligaw pa, no, parang okay, andaling sabihin na you cannot have it all, you don't need it all. Pero paano ako malalaman kung para sa akin yung isang bagay na yun, right? Doon papasok yung 10,000 hours na tinatawag.
Yun.
Kasi you really have to immerse yourself to the actual experience and the ebbs and flows of the market para makonclude mo kung saan ka talaga belong. Ang belief ko lang naman kasi dyan is that everyone naman has a place in the markets. Kailangan mo lang mahahanap kung ano yung para sa'yo at kung ano yung nag-work para sa'yo. Yun lang po.
Okay, handa. So, 10,000 hours. Di lang 10,000 hours. Meron pa yun, di ba? Yung 10,000 times. Tama ba? Yung I fear the man who practice one kick 10,000 times. Sorry, medyo na-butcher ko yung quote. Pero parang ganun.
Yeah. Bruce Lee ata.
Bruce Lee. So, yun guys. So to wrap it up, we cannot avoid information overload. Sorry to say, no, parang medyo clickbait yung title natin na how to handle information overload. Tapos yung conclusion pala natin is hindi mo din siya maiwasan. Okay? It will always be there. But even if hindi mo siya maiwasan, you can use it to your advantage by knowing exactly ano yung bibigyan mo ng focus at this phase in your trading. And siguro if meron man akong parang final words on it, it all boils down to expectation. Okay, having the right expectations sa self mo. Acceptance din. Accepting na this is something na hindi mo pwedeng madaliin. Hindi mo siya pwedeng idaan sa yung tinatawag nating brute force mentality na parang, just force everything. Ito, dapat malaman ko lahat in a single month and magiging magaling na trader na ako. It's not the case for trading and you just need to accept that. And once you have that acceptance, once you have that certain level of focus. And once you have the right expectations na, okay, this will take a while, siguro mga 2 years, 1 year, kung medyo swerte ka, talunan ka. Pero after that 1 year na you just gather data and you try to learn the ins and outs of the market, doon ka biglang, uy, nagiging break-even na ako. Uy, medyo may profits na, pero inconsistent. Until 3 to 4 years down the line, you'll see na, uy, medyo consistently profitable na ako. So yeah, it really takes time. Ang important lang here is even if there's a lot of information out there, at least you have the right community. Yun na lang yung parang pang ano natin, no? Pang offset doon sa info overload. So, you have the right community to guide you and to help you achieve that focus. So, to help you identify din sa sarili mo na, oy, ikaw, Doc Darin, ikaw, Ish, ikaw, Sir Ken, dapat based sa profile mo, ito yung bigyan mo lang focus ngayon. So, be disciplined enough to just focus on this. Anything outside of that, huwag mo muna bigyan masyado ng pansin kasi it will just overload your mind. Okay? So, yung ganong klaseng mentality, that's what we need inside TR. Okay? So, ayan. Hopefully, this answers some, if not all, of your questions on information overload. Okay? For next topic natin sa next Sunday, I think we'll be having a new guest sa TR Chronicles natin. So, abangan nyo yan. And plug ko na lang din, immersion program is set to start this coming November, November 2. So, if you're interested to apply, pwede kayong pumunta lang sa channel ng immersion program. Nandun na yung mga links for the application and mga FAQs questions na you might want to compare ano ba yung difference niya with PI and all of this stuff. So, just check on that. Or, kung ayaw niyo talaga, gusto niyo yung direct from the source, you can message me sa Discord. Okay? So, I think that's it for tonight. Thank you sa 33 viewers natin. And I think na-overload yung mga tao no, sa dami ng events. So, thank you. Enjoy the rest of the evening. And good luck sa trading week na to.